I started out by myself, right? Growing up in a small town, and you know, when I first started getting into this, nobody understood what I was doing. It's like, you know, they would be like, yeah, it's cool and everything, but it never went beyond that. You know, I have this vision to put an arm on someone, and I know it's possible. It's just technology catching up to that vision.
We are in Seattle, Washington. I just flew in today and starting to work with lead R&D manager that oversees all the prototyping to really utilize their new technologies and a lot of their R&D resources to make this custom prosthetic for a small girl named Momo and then start creating a model that's scalable across the world.
It's always been, you know, really building up to this moment of how this will affect this little girl, Momo, and how will that make her feel, and just the expression that she'll have when she sees something that is truly hers. It's not just a generic arm or hand, it's her hand.
This could be the next big jump in technology and prosthetics. This is giving us the ability to make something that looks exactly like a human hand, down to the feeling of skin and the fingers folding exactly like how the human hand does.
I've been here like 4 days now. Today I had a really awesome experience. I met with this guy named John, who oversees all of the manufacturing and production, and I had some really amazing conversations about how can we take these prosthetics and really make them as lifelike as possible.
We are currently in the Advanced Prototyping Center. We are generating all the next-gen prototypes for anything that's hardware-related at Microsoft. It's different for them what we normally do. We don't usually build prosthetics here, right? But every person wanted to have a part of it, really did.
What I was impressed with Easton is that he's looking at different technologies, new technologies that maybe aren't actually being used together right now, and how can he combine those in a way to do something new.
To get it to be not just a functional prototype, but a really beautiful one, is gonna take some work. I know he's got a lot of heavy lifting ahead of him, but I totally think it's solvable. It's hard though.
I think the next biggest challenge is fitting a lot of the mechanics into this. This is a really small space to fit everything in, but I think we can make it work.
We're gonna fail. We fail fast. You're gonna try something, it's not gonna work, and that's okay. Pivot, you know, turn a little bit, look at it a little bit differently from a different angle, and try again.
People that I've never even talked to or met before are now, you know, wanting to help as much as they can by staying, you know, after work and you know, allowing me to pick their brain and use their expertise.
I think he's close to getting his mechanicals right. I think that's the internal part, when kind of layman's term, the bones. He's got to figure out how to get the bones right. He's getting the tendons right, and that's going to be difficult.
Thing's pretty shocking, actually. It's pretty overwhelming how a little girl from Florida is connected with a young man from Durango, Colorado, who is somehow connected with Microsoft, which all involves helping Momo get her dream arm. How does that happen?
Miracle. And I'm very excited, though. I mean, you don't go to Seattle every day.
How about, do you get a new arm every day?
Nope.
How about one with fingers that move?
Nope.
That's really a dream, isn't it?
Yeah.
You know, working with John and Jeremy, we were up until 2 o'clock in the morning on Sunday, and today's Monday. So, you know, we didn't know what would happen. It's not just me working. There's teams of people that make this what it is. By doing good, good follows, and you know, by trying to help people, other people will try and help you.
Hi.
Hi. Oh my gosh.
Hi, Momo.
Hi.
Oh, it's so good to finally meet you. Sandy.
I'm Sandy.
It's been such a long time coming.
It sure has. It's so great to meet you.
Awesome. Well, I have something very cool to show you guys. You ready?
No. Oh, wow.
We even made some fingernails for you so you can, like, paint it and do all sorts of different stuff.
Oh, my gosh.
And you can move the fingers, too. So.
It was a little surprising for me too that all this large amount of people were working on this arm just for me, because not everyone in the whole entire world gets an arm like this every day.
This is John. He's been helping me a ton. He runs the Advanced Prototyping Center.
This is all about the team. The team came together and made this something amazing. I
mean, giving somebody an arm that they didn't have before, I mean, it opens up all kinds of new possibilities. I'm excited to see what she does with it, really.
Today has changed my life, not just for me, but for everyone missing a limb. When one gets it, then a couple others, then maybe hundreds and thousands. So no one feels left out.